Someone who we've worked with over the years on this event and in many other capacities.
He is a true leader in the community and perfectly exemplifies the qualities of the pioneers that have come before him. His passion and vision have not only shaped the business and technology landscape of the South Coast, but also the charities to whom he has lent his time, talent, and wisdom.
The Pioneer Award is given to an individual who has shown outstanding leadership or innovations in our business or technology community over a long period of time. In some ways, no one fits this description better than John Petote, who has been contributing to technological advancements and business growth on the South Coast for over 30 years.
When John moved to Santa Barbara from Pittsburgh in 1983, it wasn't just his desire to live by the beach that drove his eventual success. It was his ambition, business sense, and ability to adapt to a changing industry. John started CIO Solutions with just $8,000 and an apartment in Isla Vista, and weathered four recessions and two company transformations over the last 30 years. As CEO and co-founder, he was instrumental in building it into a multi-million dollar high-tech company that supports many businesses in our community by designing, implementing, and supporting customized information technology and voice communication solutions. While he has handed off the duties of CEO, he still serves as chairman of the board and continues to mentor and support the companies that, as he says, was his training ground for investing in startups.
Being the chairman of such a successful venture may be enough for most people, but not John. He describes himself as more of a business person than a technical person, and has invested in over 70 startup companies, as well as various VC funds and real estate partnerships. He has made private investments in startups focusing on information technology, internet marketing, biotech and medical devices, consumer goods, and financial industries. One of the companies he's invested in has also been awarded here tonight, AppFolio. Other local recipients of his investments are Appeal Sciences, Active Life Scientific, Invoca, Inogen, Impact Radius, and Logic Monitor. His portfolio extends outside of our community as well.
One of the reasons that John invests in the South Coast is because he believes that it is a vibrant community and a great place to start a business. He started the Santa Barbara Angel Alliance in 2016, where his role moves beyond just deciding which companies he should invest in.
John is also very generous with his time by serving on the board of several organizations, including the MIT Enterprise Forum, the UCSD Economic Forecast Project, and the United Boys and Girls Club of Santa Barbara.
He is a true pioneer in business technology and in our community. Please join us in offering John Petote the recognition he deserves for his contributions to the South Coast.
Well, the first thing I have to say is I wasn't selected for this award because of my public speaking skills. So I hope you guys can hang in there with me and you don't look like too rough for the prize. As you can see from the video, business and technology is definitely my passion. So that I'm extra incredibly honored and humbled to receive this award, especially from the Scholarship Foundation. They provide funds for high school students to further their education when they might not be able to pay for it or afford it. And I can't think of part of a better investment than that. Not that I really invest in 77 startup companies. What was I thinking? I could have put that money into a bank account. I would have had a lot less sleepless nights and a lot less volatility in my life. I could have taken a little bit more risk and put it into real estate. Most of the people I know in Santa Barbara who are self-made millionaires made it in real estate. But that wasn't enough action for me. So thinking back and really reflecting when I made my first investment 20 years ago in a private company, it was never really just about the money. It was the same when I started my company. The money is the trophy, and it's independence in my life. But becoming a mentor to these organizations and utilizing the skills that I developed over the last 30 years, building my own business, and hopefully putting odds of success on these startup companies just a little bit more than they would have had otherwise, that is the most fulfilling part for me by far. So being a mentor. Something was missing though, because I think everybody's born with some natural aptitudes, so two or three skills that come really natural to you. For me, it's probably strategy. I think I'm pretty good at reading people and assessing character and also their ability to execute. But these companies, they need a lot more than that. They need sales, they need marketing. Don't give me any accounting work to do, please. I don't like it, it wouldn't be good. And then legal, don't give me any legal work. They need technical. So I got this crazy idea over a year ago after doing startup investments for 20 years. The Santa Barbara Angel Alliance was founded. So I'm very proud it grew very quickly. We have 22 members, very serious investors. They all put their money out there, but we have the ex-CFO of Mentor Corp in there. We have the ex-CLO/CFO of Deckers. We have the ex-executive VP of marketing from Adobe. We've got technical people. We've got numerous members who have built their own companies and have had pretty positive exits. A couple of them had gone through the IPO process also. So now, we can really put the odds on these companies, the startup companies, to be successful and offer just about everything in the gamut of what they will need. So that's starting to happen, and we're starting to see the results of that. So what's happening in Santa Barbara is amazing on the startup community. Since I started again 20 years ago, the first 10 years, if you had an exit of 200 or 250 million, you were the elite, right? So that was Expert City, that was Digital Instruments. But the companies typically got bought by someone who either, didn't happen all the time, but they moved it out of town, or the companies had trouble making it because the culture didn't match that well. But now look what's happening today. We have multiple organizations that started here that are billion-dollar companies. So, Inogen, almost $2 billion right now. Procore is $1 billion. Lynda.com got bought for $1.5 billion. Yeah, this is amazing. And it's all happening maybe from the outside. It's like in slow motion, but it's really happening in my bubble pretty quickly. So, and that'll stand again to it. And these companies are now recruiting successfully from Silicon Valley. That couldn't happen before. That attracts the big VCs from Silicon Valley. This is how they're getting to these valuations, and I don't see the momentum stopping. Pretty incredible. I want to give some credit also to UCSD. When I talk to the students who are graduating from there over the years, they all tell me, hey, I want to stay in Santa Barbara, but there aren't enough jobs. Well, now these companies are sucking them up, and they're hiring them. And also this technology management program has been phenomenal. I've watched that program grow forever, so we're not just getting technical employees from the university itself, but that particular department is pumping out some incredible new entrepreneurs, and now they can stay in Santa Barbara. So I'm very happy with the direction everything's going into, and I think starting a pretty good angel group, this is a good time to do that. So who really benefits from this, and it's already mentioned earlier, is really the community. The employees, they're benefiting. The community is benefiting because the employees are paying a lot more taxes. So I want to talk about now who invested in me. Right? How did I get here? And it's been an interesting journey. So I'll start with my grandparents. All four of them immigrated here from Italy. And they only came here because they couldn't find a job where they were. My parents, we grew up kind of poor in the inner city, and they never had a high school diploma, never had a driver's license, let alone a car. And my mother, she was born with a mental disability she was diagnosed with a mental disability before I was born. So it was a little bit rough growing up. So they showered us with love, they showered us with wisdom, lots of wisdom, and that really built the foundation to really break out of the bubble that we were in. But we didn't quite get there yet, because we're still inner city kids, and most of my peers are doing naughty things, and I was doing some naughty things, and then next thing you know, they're doing more naughty things. And I knew in my gut, that's not the direction I wanted to go into. So this big arm reached out and grabbed me by the back of my collar and ripped me out of there, and that was the Boys Club. And 20 years later, they became the Boys and Girls Club, I think about 20 years. So what did I learn there? I learned confidence, the first time ever, self-esteem. It really built character. I learned how to cooperate with people much better through team sports. And they taught me this funny game called chess. And inner city kids at the time, they weren't playing chess. So there was a local tournament, I won that tournament. And then that qualified me to play the respective winners of all the boys clubs in Western Pennsylvania, and I ended up winning that tournament. So you talk about a confidence booster. So that was a huge investment in me. So I'm very proud to be on the board of directors, and there's so many great charities and foundations in town that I believe in choosing one that really reflects another person's background. So who else invested in me? So my best friend came out after 40 years. We've been together, we both broke out of the bubble together, Jim Ashendo. He flew out here from Pittsburgh just to see me get this award. And he's now the president of one of the largest limousine companies in Pittsburgh, so it's great to have that support to progress in life. Next, my lovely daughter Camila. So it could be argued that I invested in her as she's growing up, but now she's 13. And I didn't know 13-year-olds knew so much. While she's advising me, she advised me in the past, and I used to think that was cute, because I knew everything, but now at 13, I go, wow, how does she know that? So I'm looking forward to more years, and she's gonna get smarter and wiser, and she's investing in me now. Eric Gainmeyer is here.
Oh, Jesus.
I hired him, I started in 86, the company, and I hired him in 88. He was a part-time delivery guy, making about $7 an hour. Had to supply his own van. He's now one of our highest paid employees, worked his way up the ladder. And you know, without him, I don't think the company would be as successful as it is. That's what I call loyalty. So that's a definite investment in us, for me. So I want to conclude just by saying I challenge all of you. There's a lot of talent in here, a lot of accomplishment. So I challenge all of you to think in your past and think about who invested in you. And then figure out how to pay that forward in a manner you haven't already. And then just take it to the next step of the next stage if you can do it.